Star Drive and the Big Bang Part 1. Imagine gravitons having all these special qualities while floating in open space, far away from any matter, so their speed is not regulated. They all have different speeds, fast, slower, slow, some standing still, and they all have different rotations. So space is filled with gamma radiation, just to do with this, and they are filled with beta radiation are electrons. This one is a graviton going at 2c. We don't notice those. We're going at moderate speed. We notice the slow ones, we see them as positrons, and we notice the fast ones, and we see those as electrons. Although the major part of these exchange vectors of impact, some stick to each other. A certain orientation, a certain speed, and they stick to each other. Now I'm going to show you what happens. You got two of these spring-like objects. When they both turn in this direction and connect, you get a quark moving this way. When one goes that way and one goes the other way and they connect, you get a photon, because then it starts rotating as a whole. So this is not a quark, this is a photon. It's the same object, only it moves differently. Two gravitons can stick together, but a third makes a crowd. Let me enlighten. One, two gravitons stick together. A third one makes it too long and too flimsy. So either this one is going to break off again. Oh, that was my arm. I'll try again. No. Two gravitons stick together. A third one comes by. They get too flimsy and it will break off, or the other will break off. Also, when this one moves in, this one moves out. Same like the cradle of Newton. So, gravitons like to be in pairs, and that's how they become quarks. I call this mating. The two gravitons, sorry for that, two gravitons meet each other, I call it mating. Stick it in the hole, but the stick isn't there. It's just two springs who interconnect. That's all. Example here. Just like two springs. The thing is, when we overstretch a quark, it breaks loose. And then instantly it becomes two quarks. So it doubles. You have two breaking loose and a double. But it looks instantly, but in reality, it's just two breaking loose. Several others hit it, bounce through, so you don't notice they hit it. But then comes one and it sticks. So when you overstretch a quark, it looks like it instantly doubles, but that's not true. There are always surrounding electrons, gravitons, and they stick to it.